burn marks. You must have spent a whole case of ammo holding this site.
Suppose that means we missed all the fun. No one's gonna move on this place now that the Pridwin's in town.
Hi.
Paladin Dance is waiting for you inside, recruit.
Hi.
The human-looking synths are the worst. They hide in plain sight.
Hey there.
The Pridwin is a magnificent ship, and we're lucky to have her in our arsenal.
Taking on a Deathclaw without backup is a great way to get yourself killed.
Paladin Dance.
Cavalry's arrived. And it looks like they sent in the big guns.
Why did the Brotherhood send it here?
We call our ship the Pridwin. She's loaded with enough troops and supplies to mount a major offensive. If she's here, Elder Maxon's here. And that means we're going to war.
Who's Elder Maxon?
Maxon? Man's a lunatic.
Maxon is the commander of this division of the Brotherhood of Steel.
He's the model of what every Brotherhood soldier hopes to become. If we're going to war, I can promise you that he'll be leading the charge. That being said, you're about to get to know the Pridwin up close and personal. I've received orders that we're both to report to her immediately. Follow me up to the roof of the police station. We're going for a little ride.
You still here?
I'm pretty certain I gave you a mission to complete.
Quit screwing around and get out there.
We'll stop the Institute. For Maxon and for the Brotherhood.
Don't count them for taste.
Charging into a situation guns blazing is a good way to get yourself killed.
Commonwealth looks different from up here, doesn't it? It never ceases to amaze me how drastically your perception of the battlefield changes from the air. We're gonna need that edge when we take on the Institute. They've already proven that they're technologically superior, which means there's no telling what types of weapons they'll have in their arsenal. Hopefully, our air superiority and tactical know-how will make the difference. Now all we have to do is find them. And I'm betting that Elder Maxon will have a plan already in place by the time we arrive. Answer Captain Kells on the flight deck. Just stick close to me and answer all of his questions.
Thank you.
ever wondered where old planes go to die?
Permission to come aboard, sir?
Permission granted, and welcome back, Paladin. Allow me to be the first to congratulate you on a successful mission. And is this our new recruit?
Yes, sir. I field promoted him to initiate, and I'd like to sponsor his entry into our rankings personally.
Yes, we've read your reports. You'll be pleased to know that Elder Maxon's approved your request and placed the recruit in your charge.
Thank you, sir. And my current orders?
You are to remain on the Pridwin and await further instructions.
Very good, sir. Ad victoriam, Captain.
Ad victoriam, Paladin.
Well, good afternoon to you, too.
So, you're the one Paladin Dance has taken under his wing. You don't look much like a soldier to me.
And what's a soldier supposed to look like?
A soldier is supposed to be an efficient killing machine, not a relic from the past playing catch-up with the rest of the world. If Dance hadn't stepped in and vouched for you, we wouldn't even be having this conversation. Accepting outsiders like yourself has proven disastrous in the past. I've read Paladin Dance's reports. He seems to think you'll make a fine addition to the Brotherhood. You might expect an endorsement like that to grant you a great deal of latitude with us. But let me make one thing clear. The Brotherhood of Steel has traveled to the Commonwealth with a specific goal in mind. As the captain of this vessel, I won't allow anyone to jeopardize our mission, no matter how valuable they think they are. Understood?
What exactly is your mission here?
I'm not at liberty to say. Elder Maxon will be addressing the crew shortly, and I'm certain all of your questions will be answered. Now, was there anything else, or was everything I said understood?
Not even a hint? Come on. I deserve it.
Look. All I can tell you is that we're here directly in response to the data that Dance's recon team provided us. Beyond that, you'll just have to wait until Elder Maxon addresses the crew. Now dispense with the questions. It's time to get to work. Understood? That's all for now, soldier. Your orders are to proceed to the command deck for the address. After which, Elder Maxon wishes to have a word with you. If you have any questions, ask me now. Otherwise, you're dismissed.
Can you tell me anything about Elder Maxon?
Elder Maxon is the Supreme Commander of the Brotherhood. Without his tenacity and his vision, we'd still be a small group of complacent stragglers, occupying the Citadel and the Capital Wasteland. In a mere decade, he's grown the Brotherhood of Steel into a major military force. He's an inspiration to us all. Is there anything else?
Where can I get power armor?
Only knights are allowed to wear Brotherhood power armor. And you're no knight. Not yet. Until Elder Maxon grants you that title, you'll have to make do with what you've got. Anything else?
What are my orders?
Your orders are to proceed to Elder Maxon's address, after which he wishes to speak with you. Anything else?
I don't have any questions.
Then I suggest you head over to the command deck immediately. Dismissed, Initiate.
You lost. Maxon's address is being held on the command deck.
Welcome aboard. Elder Maxon is holding his address inside the command deck.
Brothers and sisters, the road behind has been long and fraught with difficulty. Each and every one of you has surpassed my expectations by rapidly facilitating our arrival in the Commonwealth. You have accomplished this amazing feat without a hint of purpose or direction, and most impressively, without question. Now that the ship is in position, it is time to reveal our purpose and our mission beneath the Commonwealth. There is a cancer, known as the Institute. A malignant growth that needs to be cut before it infects the surface. They are experimenting with dangerous technologies, that could prove to be the world's undoing for the second time in recent history. The Institute scientists have created a weapon that transcends the destructive nature of the atom bomb. They call their creation the Synth, a robotic abomination of technology that is free-thinking and masquerades as a human being. This notion that a machine could be granted free will is not only offensive, but horribly dangerous. And like the atom, if it isn't harnessed properly, it has the potential of rendering us extinct as a species. I am not prepared to allow the Institute to continue this line of experimentation. Therefore, the Institute and their synths are considered enemies of the Brotherhood of Steel, and should be dealt with swiftly and mercilessly. This campaign will be costly, and many lives will be lost. But in the end, we will be saving humankind from its worst enemy. Itself. Ad Victoria!
Ad Victoria!
Ad Victoria!
No matter how many battles we win, there's always another fight ahead of us.
Elder Maxim.
I care about them, you know. The people of the Commonwealth.
Care about them? I thought we were preparing for war.
The Brotherhood is here to prevent a war by starting one of our own. The difference is, our war won't reduce civilization to ashes.
What do you want from me?
I want you to start taking responsibility for this planet. To start making a difference. And from what I've read in Paladin Dance's reports, you've already begun that journey. Seeing as he's one of my most respected field officers, you couldn't get a better recommendation. Therefore, from this moment forward, I'm granting you the rank of knight. And, befitting your title, we're granting you a suit of power armor to protect you on the field of battle. Wear it with pride.
Only a knight? Why not a paladin like Dance?
The Brotherhood maintains a strict hierarchy, organized by rank. Paladin is several ranks above knight, and it took Dance many years to achieve that goal. With your continued loyalty to the Brotherhood, I'm certain you can attain the same. In any event, once you're finished becoming familiar with the Pridwin and my staff, report to the flight deck for your new orders. Welcome aboard the Pridwin, soldier. Make us proud.
Turbines at 87% efficiency.
Pick your targets.
Well, until command comes up with a way to identify them, I have a feeling there's going to be a lot of
green across the board, sir. Nothing new.
Good. Carry on. Congratulations on the promotion tonight.
Excuse me.
I can't believe super mutants were human once. How could science have gone so wrong?
Welcome aboard, brother. Unless you like getting radiation sickness, I'd stay away from ferals.
Dr. Ingram said she needed this suit tested yesterday.
Yeah, I get it. Just, what if I miss?
Don't.
Okay, sure. Firing. Everything holding together?
Trust me.
Good. Firing!
All right. Everything looks nominal. And you didn't scuttle the ship. Thanks, Initiate.
Sure. Anytime. Thank God.
Well, look, wondered when I'd see you again. Well, come back when you've got the time.
Dance?
There you are. How did it go with Elder Maxson?
Maxson seems so young compared to everyone else. You're okay with that?
Don't let his age fool you. Maxson's a brilliant tactician, a formidable warrior, and possesses an idealistic vision for the future of the Brotherhood. I'd follow him anywhere, without question.
Why are you so confident in his abilities?
A decade ago, the Brotherhood had almost gone completely astray. The Elder before Maxson sent us down a path that was leading nowhere. He was more concerned about charity than the preservation of technology. But when Maxson took over, he single-handedly reprioritized the Brotherhood from the ground up and put us back on the path to glory. This ship and its crew are a testament to his leadership.
He's a very dedicated man. It sounds like he stands behind everything he's saying.
Of course he does. How could he afford not to? I just hope you appreciate how much of a chance I'm taking bringing you into the fold this quickly. Not to put too fine a point on it, but if you screw up, we go down together.
So what's all this about you being my sponsor?
Elder Maxson is understandably particular when it comes to new recruits. He believes in order to keep the Brotherhood strong, we have to bond as brothers. As your sponsor, it's my duty to travel with you throughout the Commonwealth to ensure that our ideals are being observed. That's why I'm so concerned about your performance in the field.
I won't let you down, Dance. I promise.
Good. Now, I know you're eager to hop into a suit of power armor and take the fight to the Institute. But first things first. In order to be an effective part of the team, you need to learn your way around this ship and get to know its crew. Since I've been officially assigned to you as your sponsor, I'd recommend taking me along with you.
Do you need to come with me now?
It might help if I tagged along with you. On the other hand, you might want to make your first impression without a paladin standing over your shoulder. It's up to you.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Outstanding.
Well, come back when you've got this.
The Brotherhood behind us will never fall.
Hey.
You point, I shoot.
Excuse me, Paladin Dance?
Yeah?
Your thoughts?
Let's talk to Proctor Teagan. I bet he has some excellent mods for our power armor.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
Not a problem.
Hail, Knight.
By Elder Maxson's orders, all forms of technology should be confiscated or collected.
Hey.
Where do you want me?
Paladin.
Yes.
How do you feel about our relationship?
I haven't been able to make that evaluation yet. When I do, I'll let you know.
Your thoughts?
Call me old-fashioned, but there's nothing better than being boots on the ground.
That was it?
Affirmative.
Well, come back when you've got the time.
If you run into any synths, shoot to kill. We don't take prisoners.
Maxson might appear compassionate, but I can assure you, the Institute will face his wrath.
Well, wondered when I'd see you again.
Sorry, who are you?
What? Even you don't recognize me? I guess I do look a little better than when we last met. Brandis, Paladin Brandis. You pulled me out of that bunker up north, remember? Listen, I didn't have a chance to thank you properly before. I'm not sure I still have a place here. I've been away for too long. Maybe I'm not cut out for the Brotherhood anymore. But I'll give it time. I owe it to you and to my team. Thank you for giving me another chance.
Hi.
In my experience, hotshots and big mouths end up with closed casket funerals.
Thank you.
Good. You're finally here. Just set the books down anywhere. I'll get to them as soon as I can.
What are you doing with all these books?
I suppose I could stop working for a moment to address your question.
Which books contain pertinent information?
Technical volumes, repair manuals, design philosophies, medical research. Anything that enhances the Brotherhood's knowledge. That's why I consider everything else a waste of paper.
Makes sense to get rid of the trash.
Well, I'm pleased you agree. Since it's obvious that you aren't who I was expecting, would you mind telling me why you're here?
Just learning my way around the Pridwin.
Learning your way around? Ah, I see. You're the new recruit that Paladin Dance described in his report. Under normal circumstances, I provide you with a proper orientation of my department. However, I'm woefully behind setting up research patrols and getting bombarded with requests for technical documentation. Unfortunately, I'm lacking the personnel needed to get the job done.
What type of technical documentation are you looking for?
The Brotherhood is primarily interested in collecting information that might assist us with our current mission. Medical records, science journals, weapon schematics. If it contains any type of useful data, we need to get our hands on it.
Maybe I can lend you a hand.
That would be splendid. As you patrol the Commonwealth, keep your eyes open for blueprints, memos, manuals, books, charts. Anything containing useful technical data. I'm authorized to pay you for each bundle of documents that you recover. And if you wish to be assigned to a research patrol, I have plenty of them waiting to be filled. In any event, it was a pleasure to meet you, Knight.
Proctor.
Please, finish your introductions by all means. But I do hope you'll consider assisting me when you're done.
Glad you finally stopped by, soldier. Are you ready for your medical exam?
What kind of medical exam? I feel fine.
There's nothing to be alarmed about. I just have a few simple questions about your medical history. It's my responsibility to make sure that you don't bring anything up here that could pose a threat to the crew. I'm going to ask you a series of medical-related questions, and I'd like you to answer me to the best of your ability. First question. As a child, were you ever exposed to radiation for an extended period of time?
Wouldn't Vault-Tec's screening process have caught this already?
Vault-Tec's screening process? Let me check my notes here. You were a Vault Dweller? You're probably healthier than anyone else aboard. Anyway, sorry I missed that in your records. Just going down the list of questions. I'm sure you understand. Okay, second question. Have you ever had or come in contact with a person confirmed to be carrying a communicable disease?
Have you had problems with the crew catching diseases?
Well, yes, actually. It's not unusual for our recon teams to stumble across contaminated environments or disease-carrying creatures. We don't want a single crewman infecting the entire ship. Anyway, this exam is about you, so have you had or come in contact with anyone carrying a communicable disease?
Honestly, I don't remember.
Well, you don't appear to be suffering from any long-term ill effects, so I'll assume you haven't. Third question, and please answer honestly. Have you ever had sexual relations with any species considered non-human?
That happens often enough for you to have a question about it?
You'd be surprised how many Wastelanders answer yes to that question. Fortunately, the Brotherhood finds that type of behavior absolutely distasteful. Since you haven't spent too much time in the Wasteland, I'll assume your answer is no. Last question. Would you have any problems pulling the trigger on an enemy of the Brotherhood, whether they're human, formerly human, or machine?
That's more of a morals question, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I feel that the mental state of the crew is just as important as the physical.
Anyone that hesitates firing in combat due to misguided moral standards certainly isn't Brotherhood material. So what about you? Would you have a problem with it?
If my life's in danger, I'll do whatever it takes to defend myself.
That's an acceptable answer, and the most common. Excellent. I think I've got all the information I need. I see no reason to prevent you from beginning your duties immediately. If you ever need medical assistance, you let me know.
I'd just leave that if I were you.
So, you're the new knight I heard about. Glad to have you on the team. I prefer laser weapons myself.
It's a cleaner shot and leaves that memorable ozone smell behind.
Joining our cause was the wisest decision of your life, brother.
Tighten up the meter,
Macbeth.
Now split the difference.
Huh?
Now have that.
Do you want to?
No, I think you've almost got it.
Our vertebrates should give us the air superiority.
Hey.
Don't let Ingram catch you standing around. He'll be on report before you can blink.
Kells.
Now that you've had a chance to roam the Pridwin, what do you think, Knight?
Where did the Pridwin get her name?
Elder Maxon said he took the name from a work of historical fiction. Something about a man who was destined to become a king, and his journey to liberate his people from tyranny and oppression. Seems fitting for such a remarkable ship, wouldn't you say?
She's very impressive.
Yes, quite a feat of engineering, isn't she? It took the Brotherhood's sharpest minds over 2 years to design, and more than twice that to build.
Where was the Pridwin constructed?
She was constructed at Adams Air Force Base, just outside of Washington, D.C. There was a vast amount of scrap metal and salvageable components there after we defeated the Enclave. We spent the first 2 years alone gathering the parts. The rest was spent assembling. It was worth the effort.
With the Pridwin in our arsenal, we can mobilize our entire division, sending her anywhere that Elder Maxon wishes her to go.
Her presence in the Commonwealth ensures that our mission to defeat the Institute will end in victory.
Did the Brotherhood ever build other airships?
There were less advanced versions of the ship built on the West Coast a long time ago. Historical records about their current status are in dispute, but we're fairly certain that they were destroyed. In any event, I hope your tour of the Pridwin helped acclimate you to our way of life up here. I think you'll find that the more familiar you become with both her capabilities and her crew, the longer you'll survive as a member of the Brotherhood. You're dismissed, Knight.
System Delta's at 100%. Secondary Delta's standing by.
Superstructure.
Don't despair, brother. We're here to save the Commonwealth. This is self-service, brother. You take what you need.
If you're looking for ammunition
there,
and weapon mods,
try it now.
Proctor Teagan
Nothing.
Might have what you need.
I was supposed to report 10 minutes ago. If you can't fix it...
I can fix it. You're the one who decided to kick your way through a mire lurk. Got it.
So, you're the
there
new recruit
is.
I heard about.
Thanks, brother.
Not what I was expecting.
What were you expecting?
The last batch of recruits we took on were wastelanders. Dirty, beaten up, looking for a handout. They were desperate and looking for an easy out. You look like you're here for a reason. Anyway, since you came down here to meet me, we may as well get it over with. My name's Ingram, and this lovely little group... Hey, walking away like that is just plain rude. Can't be fatal.
Proctor Ingram?
So, you're the new recruit I heard about. Not what I was expecting.
Sounds like you're disappointed.
Not disappointed, just surprised. You don't look like one of the usual wastelanders we pick up. Anyway, since you came down here to meet me, we may as well get it over with. My name's Ingram, and this lovely little grease pit is where you'll usually find me. If your power armor's too tight in the crotch, the Pridwin's about to crash into the ground, or a robot's gone haywire, you come see me.
Is this where I get my power armor?
Ha! That's always the first question from the new guys. Let's see. I just fixed up a pretty decent T-60 suit. The left leg actuator's a bit sticky, but it'll keep the creeps off of you. It's sitting in Bay 3. There isn't a day that goes by on this tub without five or six things breaking down. And since I'm stuck in this rig, I'm not quite as spry as I used to be. The work tends to pile up.
You feel like telling me how you ended up that way?
That's a little personal, don't you think?
Most people in your condition would have given up. I just wanted to hear your story.
Sure. What the hell? I was fighting with the Brotherhood in the Capital Wasteland. Worked at a staging area for the Power Armor troops. Our position was along a ridge line overlooking the battlefield. I'd say it was a 100-foot drop, give or take.
You weren't aboard the Pridwin?
The Pridwin wasn't under Maxson's command at the time. It wasn't even in the Capital Wasteland. If she'd had been there, the battle wouldn't have been such a challenge. To make a long story short, the ridge I was standing on took a hit from a nuke. Sheared most of the cliff right off, and caused the platform I was standing on to tumble over the side. If I hadn't been test piloting one of the power armor suits at the time, I would have died.
Your power armor helped you survive the fall?
Yeah. It took the brunt of the impact, but I don't know if I'd call it surviving. The suit was trashed after it landed, and I lost both of my legs. Haven't walked since. Anyway, if you need any work done on your power armor, feel free to use the workshops around here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to work.
Right now, I'm cleaning the Meyer Alert scat off my boots.
Excuse me, Proctor Teagan.
Step forward, Knight. Even though they've locked me in this blasted cage, I promised that I would be fine.
Why are you in there?
I'm glad you asked. Now, this is the stowage depot. And I, as you probably already guessed, am the ship's quartermaster, Proctor Teagan. The powers that be have me locked in here, so I can keep an eye on the Brotherhood's valuables. If you need to stock up on supplies before you head out on a mission, this is the place to buy them.
Wait, buy them? Since when does the military sell equipment to its own soldiers?
Since someone dropped a whole bunch of bombs and blew up every single factory that manufactured weapons and ammunition. Keeping the Brotherhood supplied takes caps, and everyone contributes to the cause. The good news is by having a constant flow of caps, I'm able to buy whatever you bring me. Yeah, I'm mostly interested in weapons, but I'll take anything useful. Of course, if you're just looking to make a few caps on the side, I might have some extra work for you to do.
What sort of extra work are we talking about?
Oh, no. It's nothing like you're thinking. Just involves a little bit of heavy lifting and interacting with the local farms. And since I'm stuck up here manning this one-man zoo, I need someone to do the legwork for me. After you're done with the meet and greet, we can discuss the details. In the meantime, if you ever need anything else, gun, a mod, even ammo, you just let me know.
Familiarize yourself with the Pridwin's crew. Are you ready for your next assignment, brother?
What sort of assignment are we talking about?
The kind of assignment where all of the training you've done finally begins to pay off. Let's get right to it, then. Shall we? Take a look over there. That's Fort Strong. And it's infested with super mutants. Having those aberrations of nature close enough to smell is making me sick to my stomach. To make matters worse, they're sitting on top of a massive stockpile of Fat Man shells we could use in our campaign. I want you to head over there, wipe out everything that moves, and secure that stockpile. Understood?
Super mutants? I thought the enemy was the Institute.
Super mutants are no better than Sentinels. They're a reminder of man's folly when it comes to harnessing technology. Whether it's using biochemistry to manipulate genes, or trying to create life from a bunch of circuits, it's the wrong path for science. As members of the Brotherhood, it's our sworn duty to exterminate these abominations in every form. So, can I count on you to get the job done?
What do these shells do?
The Fat Man launcher is an essential part of the Brotherhood arsenal. It's a miniature nuclear payload in a man-portable format. A squad of troops armed with one of these is virtually unstoppable. If you ever have the pleasure of firing one, allow me to give you a word of advice. Don't fire one of them in close quarters. There won't be enough of you to bury in a shoebox. Is that enough to go on?
Consider it done.
Look, I realize you're eager to take the fight to the Institute, but it'll have to wait. The Brotherhood cannot allow those abominations to have a nuclear arsenal at their fingertips.
It'll be a pleasure to exterminate that mutant filth.
Now, we have a vertibird on standby, fully armed and ready to depart. Use it to carry our message to Fort Strong and wipe those dirty mutants from the face of the earth. Dismissed.
Death from above. It's the only way to fly.
Welcome aboard, Knight. Instruments are green, and we're cleared for release.
Having the Pridwin moored above the airport keeps the Brotherhood within striking distance of the city.
Target acquired. I'll try and keep him in your sights.
They gave up. Wise choice. There must be something significant in this area to merit these fortifications.
What? Who's there?
If you keep hoarding that garbage, you're going to
What's
slow
that?
Us down.
Huh? A noise. Nothing. That sound, what is it?
A noise?
Someone there?
Let's play, little human!
I'll wipe you from the face of the earth!
Judging from the amount of dust resin, it's safe to assume we're the first people to investigate this location in quite a while.
Heads up.
Awaiting your command. Remain vigilant. This place may appear abandoned, but that doesn't mean we should drop our guard.
Who knows? Maybe you're right, brother. Maybe you're right.
This area's obviously been abandoned.
There we go.
And for quite some time. Left to properly identify these remains.
My brother, hunt, but for food, for sport. Come on, yes, there, brother.
We should search this area carefully for any technical documentation or pre-war artifacts.
Something there. Oh, what's that?
Thank you.
Paladin Dance.
Look at this place. You must hate these mutants as much as I do.
Why do you hate super mutants so much?
They're responsible for the death of a close friend, a Brotherhood knight named Cutler. So when you ask if I hate them, I say hate's too gentle a word. These monstrosities are just another example of man blindly taking a step forward, only to wind up stumbling two steps back. I've been fighting for years, trying to put a stop to this madness. And just when I thought we were getting the upper hand, along come the synths. I've seen what these super mutants do to people. Can you imagine what the synths would do to us if they ever got the upper hand? It would be Armageddon repeated, and maybe the end of everything that we hold dear. Look, I don't mean to bore you with my rhetoric. I just want you to understand how important these missions are.
How could synths bring about our destruction?
If the synths reached the point where they outnumbered mankind, how long would it take for them to decide we were no longer necessary? They certainly possess the capability to make more of their own kind, so we'd become expendable. And with Institute technology on their side, nothing could stop them, not even the Brotherhood. It's a nightmare scenario almost too terrible to contemplate. Anyway, that's enough of that. What's important here is that you got the job done and secured these warheads. You should head back up to the Pridwin and talk to Maxon. I'm sure he'll want to debrief you as soon as possible. Dismissed. Head back to the Pridwin. I'll take care of the shells and the mess.
Paladin.
Ready to continue our mission, soldier? Sir. Ready to continue our mission, soldier?
I just want to trade a few things.
Very well. Help yourself. Might be able to recover some weapons or ammunition from this site. You should head back to the Pridwin. I'll take care of the shells and the mess.